Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the loading apron. We'll see what exactly is the loading apron and how many number of loading aprons should be given and what is the dimensions of the loading apron. Everything related to that we will see in this particular lesson. So to get started with, the pavement which is adjacent to or in front of the terminal building is called as your apron. Okay, so say there is a terminal building here, right, like this, adjacent to it. Adjacent is nothing but beside or in front of. The terminal building is called as apron. And the apron which we use for loading and unloading of your goods, passengers, etc. is called as your loading apron. In loading apron, we also do some fueling, that is fill the aircraft with fuels. And then do some minor servicing for the aircrafts and also certain checkups. So that particular region is called as the landing apron. You can see here. That particular type is called as the loading apron, as you can see here. Okay. So basically, see, this is the walkway for the passengers to come and sit in the aircraft. Basically, the passengers are getting loaded in the aircraft. And from below, you can see here, all the cargoes are being loaded and whatever fuel, everything has to be put into this will be loaded here, and some minor corrections and checkups also will be done at this particular point. So the other name for loading apron can be given as the parking apron, right? Basically, your aircraft is being parked there before it is ready for the takeoff, right? Normally, it is desirable to go for cement concrete pavement in case of your loading apron. The reasons for going for this type of pavement is that it will resist the effect of jet blast which will come out of the jet engines when they actually start, and also it will resist the fuel spillage, and basically it will be strong enough to withstand all the loading which is coming onto the pavement. Generally, this loading apron dimension will depend upon number of factors. Dimensions of, let us call this as LA, loading apron, will depend on, the first one is number of loading position. How many number of loading position we need, based on that we can decide the number of loading aprons. Then based on the gate positions required, where exactly your gates are required, based on that also the dimensions of the loading apron will depend. Then is the size of the aircraft which have been coming into those particular areas, and the type of the parking system which is adopted. So based on all this, the dimensions of your loading apron can be decided. Normally, these size are decided based on number of circles of varying diameter and the span through which these has to be made. These loading aprons has to be made will depend upon the wingspan. Wingspan is nothing but this aircraft wing length. Okay, this is your wingspan, and that will depend upon the length of the wings, on the length of turning radius, all this under the use of the airport. Okay, the number of aircraft stands to be provided is determined from the peak aircraft movement per hour. Okay, how many parking stands we have to provide, that will depend upon the capacity of the aircraft movements per hour during peak time. Okay, and generally between two parking regions, a clearance of about 7.5 meters standard is provided. So this is about your loading apron. Hope it is clear to you now. Thank you.